Hey guys! Today's video comes to you in two parts. I have a box that could so easily be made into a fort. Give me ideas for what to decorate it as, because I was thinking maybe a house or a rocket ship. But there are a lot of options. It could be a boat. I don't know. But I have some free time. Not really, but I'll pretend I do. In which I could color it and make it all pretty. So let's do that. I'm in a box. I'm in a box and it's going fast and I got a nautical theme patch me in the eye. Yeah, it should totally be a boat. Part one. I think that my house has some weird little bits that make it kind of comical. First off, there's a, we have these wardrobes in the hallway and two of them have some weird features to them. One of them is kind of broken in a way that makes me, you know, speculate about what could have happened to the wardrobe to make that happen. I assume some very drunken nights with people falling into it, possibly some people attacking it with various kitchen items, I don't know. But I'm hopeful that that has a good story behind it. The next is a weird ventilation system on somebody's wardrobe. I can only pray that one person a couple years ago had it. It had some really weird odor problems. And that's just had to be dealt with. So they put in a vent for that shit. Okay, next. And really, last of this part, are the drains in our sink. So, this is our kitchen sink, and you'll note the X-Men style drains. That is the X-Men logo. I was really excited when I realized this today. Horribly excited, like, probably way too excited. I wish you all the luck in the world finding cool things like that. Make a video with that in it. That being said, Chelsea's challenge this week was those TV shows that you watched as a kid. And I have to say, I'm gonna sit for this because I'm getting a bit in pain by leaning. I have to say that mine was definitely Pokemon. I was so into Pokemon. Agreed with Erin. I had a bunch of cards. I named my hamster Eevee. My brother's hamster's name was Drowsy. We clearly had some Pokemon-y problems. But the one that I'd really like to talk to you guys about, because you guys all know Pokemon, that's not a really big deal. I was super into Blue's Clues. Like, super into Blue's Clues. So Chelsea, when you said that, I got really excited because I was really, to a ridiculous age, I was like third grade, fourth grade, in which I was still like, Blue's Clues is the shit, guys. Also, I could do a decent Blue impression. We just got a little. That's a really good song from Blue. The show that I really want to talk to you guys about is called Tailspin. I'm pretty sure none of you know it. I don't particularly remember all of it anyway, but I know I watched it all the time when I was a kid because my dad had recorded a bunch of the episodes of it. There weren't a lot of them. It wasn't a particularly popular show, but it had the best theme song in the world and it's still on my iTunes to this day because it was so good. I'ma dance to it now. Okay, so really what you need to focus on about how awesome Tailspin was that it was Baloo, the bear, from The Jungle Book. But guys, I don't really know The Jungle Book. I've never been particularly familiar with The Jungle Book because I just know Baloo from Tailspin. He flew a plane. He had his plane, a little propeller engine plane, and it was, he kind of owned this delivery service, and a woman worked for him. By woman, I mean another bear. worked for him and had this little son who always wanted to go on adventures with him, and he was like, oh, slow down there. And I love it so much, and it just had really good kind of like plots, and it was a good show. But the theme song was amazing, as evidenced by my dancing. So, I hope this was to your liking. Katie, I need to watch Downton Abbey. I know that I haven't. Obviously, I know that I haven't. My mom's obsessed with it. It's been trying to get me to watch it. And yeah, I've heard amazing things about it. I just haven't watched it yet. Because I'm a bad person. Can't really explain that. Yeah. I love you all. I will see you on your respective days. Cool. Night! Oh, side note. Today's video camera was propped up by Pride and Prejudice with Zombies. Really good. Read it if you haven't. It's actually really fun. I mean, I still 100% prefer Pride and Prejudice by itself, because I love that book. Like, rereading this, I'm just like being hit by moments of, oh, Pride and Prejudice glory. But instead, there were some zombie attacks, and I love me some zombies, so I like it. I like well-known Pride and Prejudice characters slowly becoming zombies. That's great. Who doesn't want a bit more of that in their life? Okay, love you guys. I'll see you around the interwebs. Woohoo!
Stop, or else I'm gonna keep doing it, and it's so much fun. You guys should just dance to that song all the time. I'm gonna link to it in the comments, not in the comments, in the doobly-doo, because it's just so much fun to dance to. I'm in light. I found the light. Box earthquake!